Hi, this is Arvin, your instructor for this session. In this video session, we will be learning five commonly used count functions. That is count, COUNTIF, COUNTIF, COUNTA or COUNTA, and COUNTBLANK. Let's start without wasting a time. The first function which we will see is count function. Basically, it is used to count the cells which are having numeric value in a column. The syntax for count is equal to count and highlight and select the column which you need to count. In the second example, we will see for the dates. In date column, I have took one date in incorrect date format. If you can see, after applying the formula, it shows as 7 instead of 8. This is because count function does not count incorrect date values. In the next, that is in third example, as you can see, there are text and numeric values. We will apply count for country column and we can see the output as 3. This is because count function only calculates numeric values. That's why the output is 3. The next function which we will be having is COUNTIF. COUNTIF function is used to count the cells with single criteria. It can be used to calculate the cells with dates, numbers and text that matches with specific criteria. On the screen you can see the name, country and the revenue data table. In the first example, we want to calculate revenue over 100 using COUNTIF. And the syntax is COUNTIF, then select the revenue range and then the criteria as greater than 100. And please don't forget to use double quote. You can see the count as 10. If you cross check the highlighted cell in the table, the values are matching. Now, in the second example, we will count the cells which is equal to Jim. Like above, we will use as same and the criteria will be given as Jim in double quote. In this way, we can calculate for specific country as well. By using COUNTIF, we can also calculate the duplicate cells. We will use as is equal to COUNTIF, and in range and in criteria we will use the same range, means the criteria and the range we will select it as range only. After pasting the formula below by Ctrl D or paste formula, we can identify the cells which are having duplicate values. We can also calculate by duplicate in using conditional formatting. However, to filter out the duplicate without deleting this is the best option for you. The next function which we'll see is COUNTIFS. It is used to count the number of cells with multiple criteria. As we learnt in COUNTIF, there is one criteria. However, in COUNTIFS, there are multiple criteria. In the table, you can see the product with country-wise sale for the persons. If we want to calculate how many times Sarah sold a product D to Australia country, here we have multiple criteria. Type equal to COUNTIFS criteria range. Then criteria as Sarah, again criteria 2 range and criteria as D, product D, again criteria 3 as country Australia. Now you can see the count as highlighted. You can also cross check the value which we are getting is correct. In second example, we have to calculate how many times Sarah achieved goal target above 50. Here we have to only give the criteria as greater than 50. Apart from this, all the same. I have created two examples for your practice. You can practice this two examples. Now, The last function which we will be learning is COUNTA or COUNTA function. This function is used to calculate the number of cells that are not empty. COUNTA function returns numeric value. On a screen, we have a column with mixed data in cell. If we apply the formula, you can see the answer as 11, as COUNTA function does not count the empty cells. In second example, we want to calculate the cells which containing only text values. For that, we will first calculate the values by COUNTA. So it will give the total occupied cell value numbers. And we will subtract the count, as we studied it counts the numeric values. So we will subtract that formula in COUNTA function. In this way, we can mix two formulas as well. The last function of today's agenda, which we will see, is COUNTBLANK. Its use is very simple. It is used to calculate the blank cells. We have covered all the topics for today's session. Please let me know if you have any queries or questions. I will be happy to answer them. Till then, signing off. Keep learning, keep growing with Arvind Techs, and please do subscribe our channel to get the latest updates.